Well, I'm joined by Mr. Bruce Stewart, who's the president of Direct Energy. Bruce, thanks so much for being here today.
Great to be here, Montel. Thanks for having me.
Absolutely. Look, you know, it's really a tough time right now. You know, people are hunkered down. 85% of the entire country is staying at home, trying to stay home. And, you know, they're walking around the house using up as much energy as they possibly can. What have you been doing to help make sure that your company stays focused on your consumers?
As we're focused on our over 3 million customers in providing electricity and natural gas, as well as home services, we're fundamentally been labeled by all of the states that we operate in. We're also in Canada as well, as an essential service. So we know how absolutely important it is to keep our economy running and to keep our, frankly, our customers safe and healthy, is to keep our services running for them nonstop. So in addition to making sure we have reliable electricity and natural gas, right, and that we're helping our customers who may have been impacted, unfortunately, maybe they're out of work for a moment, how do we help them, you know, deferred payment plans? How do we help make sure that they can avoid any loss of energy, which would be really challenging at this point in time. But we also have thousands of technicians that could come in and help them if something in the house breaks.
How has your company been impacted right now?
We have lots of technicians that go into homes and help repair those HVAC units. They are still active. They are still day in, day out, taking the proper steps to do safely and with the intention of their own safety and the own attention to their own health, as well as our customers, are taking extra protocols. And you've got to have these day in, day out sort of appliances and key things working properly. So those folks are on the road, continue as an essential service, providing that service. So that's one element. And then we had to bring all of those call center agents and other folks to work from home, including all of our regular business employees are working from home day in, day out, set up with screens just like I am, working from kitchen tables and from extra guest rooms and from, you know, their own home offices, whatever it may be. And it's actually working. It's really interesting. And because our number one focus is how do we make sure we continue service for our customers and do it in a safe way to keep everybody healthy and help us all get through this.
What's your company doing looking ahead to continue to meet the needs of our energy supply a year from now?
That's a great question. And the question is, are things that we've been doing need to be completely revisited? And I think there are a couple, Montel. I think that's really important. But then are there other things that have been true all along that continue to be true? So the notion that, do we want to continue to help customers get availability to sustainable resources, to help them be green, as folks might often think about it? And how do we help them do that? Increase digital service capabilities to do everything from paying your bill to switching your service to adding service capabilities and doing all that, if you will, in a highly digital way. Those are things that are real imperatives for us as a business coming out of that will help keep us as a really strong company to be able to continue to serve our companies, even as sort of the energy markets sort of ebb and flow and these kind of, you know, unpredictable, unprecedented incidents happen, knowing number one, that, you know, if we have to be back in our homes at any future time, we've got to be able to deliver that energy safely and reliably.
Yeah, well, you know, I think that we all have to do our part, including the consumer. So do you have any tips that they can have right now to maybe help save a little bit on energy? I mean, you know, people are walking around, they probably have extra lights on in the house. They're probably, you know, running some things in the house that really are unnecessary. How about some tips to help everybody kind of conserve?
There's tips that are always good for any time, even if we're not all sheltering from home. Think about the time shifting of when you're using some of those appliances. Could you push some of the appliance use into later in the evenings? And frankly, a big one, Montel, a really big one is we have lots of big appliances that when you look at the overall energy consumption, those are big units that actually consume roughly 80% of the power in your home. So if those are in good operating condition, they're running efficiently, right? Maybe you might need to step into a new unit that actually runs more efficiently. That will save a lot of energy and lower your bills, which is really important for customers.
Bruce, I can't say thank you enough for spending the time with us today, giving out some tips, helping us all understand that we're in this together, and it's companies like yours that are gonna keep us up and running. So thank you so much. You have a great day. Stay safe, stay home, take care of your family.
Montel, thank you so much. Really appreciate the time.
Absolutely. Thank you.
Take care.
For more information, all you got to do is go up on our website, thebalancingat.com. We'll be back right after this.